I'm Shane and welcome to Rockin' the Planet, the show that is dedicated to bringing New Zealand live music to your television screens, not only in New Zealand Music Month, but every single week of the year. This week we have a show full of great original music. We have live music and interviews with My Sex drummer Paul Dunningham, re their Reformation, and bass player extraordinaire Tony Waine from the top Kiwi band of the 80s, The Narcs, to tell us all about his brand new project called Brave Sheep, featuring some of New Zealand's greatest musical talent. But first, who's been rocking the planet this week? First, some great news though. Here's an album that is definitely a must for my collection. It's a collaboration featuring performances by top artists performing Paul McCartney songs called The Art of McCartney, who arguably has to be the biggest selling composer of all time. It's a who's who of talent: Billy Joel, Brian Wilson, Steve Miller Band, Willie Nelson, Barry Gibb, and Roger Daltrey, to name a few. But the star has to be Bob Dylan, singing Things We Said Today from A Hard Day's Night. Look out for that, The Art of McCartney. Now, stranger than fiction is Morrissey, the former lead singer of the 80s band The Smiths. He's heading out on an all-American tour. To start it off, he has the legendary Welshman Tom Jones as a support act. And 4 weeks later, he has Cliff Richard as his support act in New York. Apparently, Morrissey is a huge fan of both singers. Cliff is over the moon and thrilled to be having the chance to be playing to 12,000 people in New York. Good on you, Cliff, Morrissey, and Tom. Now, new faces on the planet. Last week I found a set of sisters that you had to see, the Cadbury Sisters. This week I found another set. From Tennessee, we have the Secret Sisters, Laura and Lydia Rogers, being likened to a female Everly Brothers. So let's have a listen. Going places, the Secret Sisters. Not a secret any longer. My next guest, I am really excited about. They have a fantastic project. His name is Tony Waine, and he has a project called Brave Sheep. Now, you wonder what Brave Sheep's all about. He's going to tell us, and I am so interested. They're doing great things. Let's welcome Tony Waine.
Thanks, Shane. It's a real pleasure, Tony, to meet you.
Good to have you here, mate.
In this formal situation.
I've been a fan of yours for years. I love the Narcs. Now, you were the bass player for the Narcs. Tell us all about the Narcs.
The Narcs. I believe
you're still playing.
Oh, we did a gig in Mills Reef not long ago. Yeah. We play about every year or so these days. The Narcs were a Christchurch band, and I always get asked, where did you get that name, the Narcs, from? Well, we're a three-piece, and just at that time that we formed, there was a band that was called The Police, and we thought, that is such a ridiculous name. Oh. Why would you call a band The Police? So we decided to call it The Narcs.
Perfect.
I know.
Perfect. What a great little story.
I know. And it just started It just started off that way. We were incredibly fortunate to have an Australian guitarist. So we were immediately different. Mm-hmm. We had this nasty sort of Les Paul going, and had a bit of rose tattoo.
Yeah,
mix.
He was good. He was
Midnight
good.
Oil. Yeah. And that wasn't going on when we...
in the 80s. And it did have a strong keyboard thing, I remember.
That came later. Yeah. Liam came in about 3 years later and taught us A minor and B flat, and we were completely stuffed after that.
Lovely guy, Liam, yeah. Before we go any further, let's listen to one of the great tracks from the album. And this is fronted by a national treasure of ours, the lovely Shona Lang. Let's go out dancing till we can dance no more. Let's go out grooving till the early hours. Make them think they'll soon be sending flowers. Groove like teenagers should not be out. Let's go out grooving now, now, now. I should leave but my legs are stuck. Can't break away from this beat. We get lost all the time to the sounds of the street. there it is, Going Out. What a great track, I love it.
Now, that's great, because I came back in 81, 82
right.
from England and settled back here.
Right.
And the Narcs were big star. They were just really starting to hear about the Narcs. And of course, then I followed your career. I mean, I was a fan of yours. I loved Diamonds. What was it, Diamonds?
Diamonds on China.
On China.
Yeah.
And the other big hit that you had, that Dave McCartney, I believe, produced.
Yeah, Dave McCartney. When it came time to do an album, we'd sort of been through the hurdles with record companies of doing an EP, a single, another EP. Now, let's do an album. So we thought, who can we get? And we all absolutely loved Dave McCartney.
Yeah.
Because he had this sort of pop sensibility, alti rock, whatever it was, he was great,
and he was a great guy. He communicated well. He was easygoing,
easy to work
with.
Wasn't a heavy dude. Like skiing, we did two ski tours with him.
Yeah, we did love skiing.
Two beach tours, and we did the album at Mandrill Studios.
Yep.
And Graham Meyer was the engineer, and actually Dave won producer of the year for that, and we recorded that album. I know we did the rhythm tracks in about a day and a half.
So there's a lot of crazy people involved in that record. Believe me, I know Graham Meyer.
No, it was fantastic. And he really, he created a whole new sound for the band.
Yeah, and you had a great sound. And you've moved on since then. Life after the Narcs, I mean, what happened?
Well, I went a bit crazy. And then I went to Australia.
You too.
I did, and I worked in show bands over there. And I was working six nights, seven nights a week, doing crazy things like that. I absolutely loved it. I loved just going to somewhere else and playing in a different place, because you play so long in one place and you lose track of how am I actually playing?
So
you go somewhere new, and it was just incredibly refreshing for me to jump into a whole lot of show bands and play around Australia.
Yeah, without
the pressure. Absolutely loved it.
Just have some fun.
Play bass. I threw my pick away because I kept losing it.
Now, apart from bass, you're playing guitar.
Yep.
You play keyboards. I think you play most instruments these days.
I do in a studio, but you can kind of, you can take your time in the studio.
Now, what I really got you here for was to talk about the project. So this is a huge project, a huge undertaking.
It
lots
is.
Of musicians from all around the country and writing songs together.
Yeah. What it was, I've been teaching music. I work at Mains, which is the Music and Audio Institute in New Zealand. Mm-hmm. And I decided to do a master's. And part of that master's was to, besides the academic writing and the interviews that you and the research that you do, there was this opportunity to do something creative. So I took it with both hands and wrote an album, a collaborative album, because the master's focused on collaborative writing, songwriting, contemporary collaborative songwriting, which is basically pop. So I contacted all the people I've always wanted to write with, Shona Lang, Hammond Gamble, Ricky Morris, Andy, my mate from the Narcs, Jordan Luck, Dave McCartney. The story was that I was looking around for songs and ideas, and all the ideas were different for each song. You soon realise that every song is totally different the way it's sort of constructed, obviously. And a friend of mine in Christchurch, Kent Caddick, sent me a poem that he wrote about the earthquakes in Christchurch, and it was called Munted in Brighton.
I've seen that,
And so I thought, I'm going to write a song with this. So I did. I wrote the melody, and I did a demo, and I took it to Jordan Luck. And he said, I love that. I love that.
Very Jordan.
So he wrote a few other little bits and pieces for it, and we went into the studio, and Dave McCartney came in, and I borrowed a 12-string Rickon backed guitar from Roger and all his good folk at Music Planet.
There you go.
We did. That's why. That's why it's working.
Yeah.
That's why.
Of course it is. That's just a little stardust sprinkled up.
So Dave, bless his heart, Dave McCartney put down this incredible 12-string Rickenbacker sound throughout it, and it's I think the good thing about the magical thing about collaboration is you just go somewhere where you never thought you're going. You know, it's like getting in a car by yourself and you go, I'm just going here. But if you've got all these crazy mates in your car, you could end up.
You don't know where you're going to go. I mean, really, you don't.
No.
And
it,
you go
especially
on a journey
Jordan
together.
Especially with Jordan Luck and Dave McCartney in the car.
Exactly. You never know. Will you be here today? Will it be the other? Will it be the other Jordan or will it be the other Jordan?
I don't know. Yeah.
But anyway, yeah, and that's what it's all about, collaboration. Yeah. And you grow a bond between you all. And I just saw the clip before and I just was amazed at the musicality of it all and the beautiful tunes that you're churning out. Yeah.
So here's Tony with his own solo effort from the project and it's called Brown Smoke. Great song, Tony. Now, if you're a budding musician and you desire to aspire to greatness in the music world, you need to go no further than Music Planet. Now, they're friendly, helpful staff. They know their stuff. All being respected musicians themselves, they will help get you started no matter what your budget. New strings, new drum skins, a piano, a guitar, they've got it in stock. 9 stores throughout New Zealand, Music Planet. Now, on with the show.
I mean, every track on there is a stunner, you know. It's going to be a fantastic album. It was released on April the 28th.
At the moment, at the moment it's on Bandcamp. So if you go onto Bandcamp and you look up Brave Sheep.
Okay.
There's 9 tracks there.
Yeah.
And before it goes too crazy, it's all free.
Well, there you go. It's free at the moment.
So you can listen to it, stream, or you can download it.
Yeah, download it. Download it. It's fantastic. Yeah, you're from Christchurch, you're a good Christchurch boy.
I am.
The home of many a great musician.
Many, many, many.
They've all come from
Funny there. Story about that is that my dad and his dad were men's hairdressers.
His dad?
My dad.
Your dad?
And my grandfather.
Oh, your grandfather, sorry. His dad?
That's what they call them.
Okay.
And anyway, there was this young fella that dad used to cut it. I think it was at Medbury College because they used to go around all the colleges like Christ College in Medbury. And one of them was this little fella called Ray Columbus.
Oh, right.
So my dad used to cut his hair.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. And Ray, when I first met Ray in the mid-80s, when I put this band together, or the Narcs, we put a band together in the sort of the off-season called Vibe Brigade. And we used to get people in to come and have a bit of a sing.
Yeah.
And Ray was one of them. And I told him the story about, you know, my dad and everything. And since then, we've always sort of said hello and had a good chat. Yeah. And he's been a damn fine fellow. And he's a trooper.
He's a real trooper. He's a battler too, and he's still going strong.
You know the great thing about Ray?
Fighting on you.
He always says yes.
And he had a good hairdresser.
He did.
It looks like you've got a pretty good hairdresser. You're doing pretty well. There's no shortage of hair there, mate.
No, it might be the wrong colour. You know,
Don't worry about that. Grow old gracefully, as they say. Anyway, you're not looking too old. Good
Thank
day
you very
having
much.
You, mate. Tony,
Shane,
all the best
it's
with
a
your
pleasure
project.
To meet you too.
It really is a pleasure.
Thank you. Okay.
Now, just a reminder, if you love live music, come along and join us on Friday nights at Ohinerau Street in Remuera at the CT Club. And be part of our studio audience while we film our live band of the week. Our next live band is Northland's Jim Wallace and Sons, The Outlaws. Friday the 9th. We look forward to seeing you there.
And now my next guest. I'd love to welcome a man from my sex. And I'm not talking about my sex. His sex, but my sex. Anyway, great band, my sex. Classic Kiwis. And it's Mr. Paul Dunningham, the drummer. the drummer from hell, I tell you. You're one of the best drummers I've ever met in my life.
Appreciate that, Joe.
Yeah, it's good to have you here, mate.
Great to be here.
And now, look, you
guys... The wine's good.
Your wine's good.
Yeah.
You did a good little tune on there before.
I can get that happening. Yeah, I can sort of... See, I'm cool. I can just do it.
Totally musical drummer.
It just happens.
I've always said that about you. You're the most musical drummer I know. And always a pleasure having
that's
you.
That's a C, by the way.
Working, that's a C, is it? Oh, thank you for that. Look, I'll talk and see. but good to have you here. And what I want to discuss with you, really, is the fact that my sex are back on the road doing things. I mean...
After 30 years.
After 30 years. Of course, the wonderful Steve Gilpin passed away and had an accident and so on. And so it put the band basically out of action for a while.
Yeah.
But now you're back and you've got a new vocalist.
Yeah, we've got Steve Balby, who's the bass player, for, as much as other things, he's the bass player for Noiseworks. So he's well known in Australia as the bass player for Noiseworks. But yeah, he's joined us and he's doing a great job and not trying to copy Steve Gilpin, which is fantastic.
And that's important.
Yeah, it is important. Yeah,
that's important.
He's made it his own and it's working, you know.
Yeah. That's where a lot of them try too hard to be who they're supposed to be.
That's a big mistake, isn't it?
Mistake. And just be... join the band and try and be part of it.
Yeah,
much more.
Yeah, you respect the memory of the original singer. Any band that loses their singer, you don't want to sort
of
pretend that he didn't die and you've replaced the same thing. And you know, that's a different chapter, you know.
And Steve was, a hard act to follow. I mean, he was incredible.
Oh, amazing.
Now, I was in Upper Hutt recently working down there myself, and you were there probably the week before. I saw all the posters up still, and I thought, wow. And I inquired, I said, how did they do? And they said, you packed the joint.
March 28th.
Yeah. And apparently you packed them in. So the houses are still full. Everyone wants to see my sex.
Yeah, we've got this great guy, John Aleph. He's the agent here, and he runs Peak Entertainment. Yeah. And so it's sort of toes in the water. You know, before these 3 dates we did, we weren't sure if there was actually any interest here. As it turned out, there was nothing to worry about. But we didn't know. Who knew that it would still be popular?
You were held in very high esteem here, I'm sure. You had wonderful hits like Computer Games and all the other great hits. Are you looking at recording again, the band? Are they going to go back in the studio? Because I know there's a huge demand out there. I'd love to hear a record.
We are in the studio, yeah. We've recorded 3 songs.
Yeah.
And at Murray Burns' studio in Byron Bay. So we've already started.
So you're over there. Are you going back over there to record very soon?
Yeah, we're doing some more shows in Australia in August, doing... Got another couple of weekends in August, and then we've got another weekend at the end of August in New Zealand.
And will you come back? I'd like to see you back here in the summer.
Yeah.
When we've got our, you know,
yeah, like
beach
a winery tour or a beach tour or something.
That's where you've got to be.
Yeah.
We'll try and come back for that. So let's have a listen to My Sex from the 80s, fronted by the extremely talented late Steve Gilpin. Got a proper job, as they say. I mean, all us musos have a proper job, believe me. We don't just sit around swanning around spending millions and
it's almost a proper job,
and drinking and smoking and doing all those things. We are quite ethical. We have a good proper job now.
Even responsible sometimes.
Responsible sometimes. Yeah. And you are one of the most responsible people I know. You've got a proper job. You teach music.
Yeah, I teach drumming around. I'm an itinerant drumming teacher, so I teach at 5 schools. And at home.
This is all in Auckland?
Yeah, all in Auckland. And I often send my students to Music Planet to get their drumsticks.
I was going to ask you about
and
that.
And resources, actually. You know, music resources. So
Now, did you hear that music, Planet? This is our sponsor. Now, this man sends his students to you. And of course, I agree, because Music Planet is the place where you go.
Yeah.
They're all musos there.
Yeah.
They can help you out. Everybody can
Fantastic
help you
place,
out.
Yeah.
Do a great job. And so you send all your students there.
I send them
Great
there,
start
yeah.
for them, I tell you.
Yeah.
Now, your previous lead singer, Steve Gilpin, who yeah. was great and a real arch of the band, I toured with him when he was still Steve Gilpin before he formed the
yeah.
My Sex with You guys. And he was just the loveliest guy. And I remember he had an air ticket. He was doing cabaret then.
Yeah.
And he had an air ticket. I had my band, The Road Show, with Dave Russell and Jimmy Hill and guys like that. And we just finished a gig at some pub in Napier.
Yeah.
And he had an air ticket back to Wellington. We were driving in our van.
Yeah.
So he let the air ticket go and said, I'd rather come with you guys in the van, be more fun. He was dying to get into a band.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, yeah.
He wanted to get into a band. And he travelled with us all the way to Wellington, and we had such a good laugh and a good time. Always a great guy, and he really had his path patched where he wanted to go.
Yeah.
I mean, did you find him the same? When you formed the band, he was still singing cabaret when I last saw him.
Well, yeah, well, I joined the band in 81, so the band had already formed.
It evolved.
But I was involved in the process, the evolution that became, you know, eventually became My Sex. I was in a band called Brigade in Christchurch with Kevin Stanton.
Yeah.
And that band then moved to Auckland, and we toured around North Island.
Yeah.
And Steve had sort of come, he'd started coming to see Brigade. When he was in Christchurch at one point, he turned up to see us playing. So he became friends with Kevin Stanton.
Yeah.
And when My Sex first started, I was offered the job and I turned it down. I could, you know, I was offered the job in 1978.
Yeah.
But of course, I was doing six nights a week in Auckland, and I thought I was, I was in the big time. And so I said, no, Kevin, I think I'll stay with my six nights a week. But luckily, they offered me the job again in 81. So, so I joined. But
on a good choice too.
Yeah.
You're one of the best drummers I know. I mean, really are. I can't sing your praises enough. So let's get up to date with My Sex and Steve Balby, fronting the band, doing a fine job of filling the shoes, and big shoes they are, of the late Steve Gilpin. I've got to ask you one thing. I mean, like we asked everybody, where did it start? This drum thing. I mean, what made you pick up the sticks and want to play drums?
My father was a fantastic musician. He was a trombone player,
and
he was an arranger, and he was a band leader, and he was a drummer. And I remember as a kid, as a little kid, like, you know, 7 or 8 years old, watching Dad. I'd see him go to gigs, he'd jump in his car with a trombone case. That was okay. I thought, oh, that's good, Dad's off to play the trombone. But when I saw him loading the drums in the car, I remember that sort of
this
struck a chord. I thought, oh, loading drums in the car and going off with those drums. There was something about that whole picture. And so I don't know why, but that kind of picture was kind of neat.
Yeah.
And then Dad would start taking me to gigs, his gigs, and I'd be watching the gigs until I fell asleep, and Dad would wake me up at the end of the gig and take me home. But you know, because he used to play on shows and things, His Majesty's Theatre and
so
stuff.
So used to sit under the tom-tom.
I used to fall asleep under the timpani and stuff, you know.
Yeah.
But that was how it started,
That's how it started. It planted the seed.
Yeah.
And then when did you get your first band sort of thing? When did you obviously went home and practiced. Dad taught you to play?
Yeah, Dad taught me how to drum, and then he signed me up to the Newland Citizens Band, the brass band. So I started marching in farmers' parades and Anzac parades and things, and winning snare drum contests and things through the late 60s.
Practice your paradiddles.
I knew the paradiddles and the rolls and the flams. And then I left school in 73 and worked for the Auckland Drug Company for a while as a storeman. And
when was this, in the 60s?
It was 1973.
That was a bad time to be working with the drug company.
Yeah.
Anyway, go on.
And when I got fired from the drug company, luckily I had a job at about, I was always late for work. And luckily I had a job playing at one of Johnny Tabler's clubs, the Do Re Mi in Queen Street. So I had a job in a band playing from 9 at night to 4 in the morning.
That's where you honed your craft.
Yeah, that was really paying your dues in those days, playing for 7 hours a night. That was kind of crazy. Yeah, I look back now crazy and think, stuff. How do we do 7 hours a night? But we did. We did 9. And even if there's no one there in the club, if there's just one drunk in the corner, we had to play till 4 in the morning.
Yeah, and you go back and do it again the next
night. Yeah. And we were quite happy doing that,
thinking,
you know.
Right, off to work.
Yeah. And then you mentioned Dave Russell. I worked with, I did a John Rolls tour in 1974. A 7 week national tour, and Dave Russell was playing guitar.
He was the guitarist.
He was fantastic to work with us when you mentioned.
And of course, Dave Russell being the guitarist for the Invaders, Ray Columbus's band.
Yeah, so I was playing with him, and Billy Nooker was on drums. I was playing percussion, I was playing timpani and stuff, but Billy Nooker, I learned a lot from Billy just being on the road with Billy Nooker, who'd been the Mary Volcanics drummer, and he'd been with John Rolls for years. So I watched this very seasoned drummer, and I learned a lot off him. And still, one of the highlights of my career is the John Rolls tour of 1974. It was just so exciting, you know.
And you learned so much on that tour.
Yeah.
So that's where it all started. And look at what's happened.
Yeah.
What a great career.
Still playing, yeah.
I hope it continues.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah.
And good luck to My Sex with their tour coming up in September, October, back in New Zealand again.
I think we'll be in Napier. It's late August. We're doing Napier. We're doing Auckland. I think we're doing the Juice Bar in Auckland. We're doing Napier. We're doing Dunedin and Christchurch.
Well, there you go. We'll all be there. Be sure to go. My Sex. And thank you very much to Paul Dunningham.
Thank you.
Well, make sure you go and catch those guys, My Sex, when they return to our shores later in the year. Now, if you do like live music, remember you can catch up with us at the CT Club in Ohinerau Street, Remuera, Friday nights, 7:30 p.m. to cheer, clap and dance to our live band of the week. Next week we'll be listening to Jim Wallace and Sons, The Outlaws. Well, thanks for joining me here on Rockin' the Planet. I'm Shane, good night, and let's rock out with some vintage Paul McCartney.
Michelle, my bell, these are words that go together well. My Michelle. I love you, I love you, I love you. That's all I wanna say. Until I find